So that was the justification for making this study. Once we decided to have this one, we did a small brainstorming, how to start the study, how to implement the study. It's not just like that. So first we decided to cover all the states, major rice growing states, number one. Once this is decided, then we identify the implementing, who will do the research for us. We don't want to send our EB Tata team to each state, that will be biased. So we selected those implementing partners who are not promoters of SRI, who are not pro-SRI, okay? So even some universities are implementing SRI, so we did care so that the institution or research unit or the team who are implementing the study is unbiased. So that was one. Then what next stage is, who are the sample farmers? So that also we were very carefully brainstorming. So first we eliminated those farmers who are directly coming under the experimentation by the universities or research stations with the high subsidies. So we eliminated the list of farmers who are directly enjoying the some benefits. Second only, we put a condition, those sample farmers should be within 1 or 2 years, 2 to 3 seasons of the starting SRI, not 5 years of SRI adoption. So because this is, we are studying mostly on the adoption behavior and the performance of the SRI. The scope is not disadoption. The scope of the study on disadoption will be a different one. So this is limited to only adoption levels and the performance of the SRI at different adoption level and the different soil irrigation conditions. That was the major one. Then we put a uniform sample size across the states and we asked to do that. That was the best one. Then we prepared a template to collect the data. We didn't allow everybody to collect whatever is available. So we prepared a questionnaire, a template, pre-tested that one according to state. Then we finalized that one for the implementing the survey schedule. That was the basis to start the study. So this is a sample we distributed almost, actually it was 2600, but some were eliminated because of lack of data. There was a inequity in the sample because it's not intentional. They don't get the sample farmers. That was the case with the implementing team. In a particular, because we approach a cluster of villages, approach a district and cluster of villages, so they could not find enough SRI farmers from the list. As such, there is no list maintained as SRI. Government is maintaining SRI farmers once they implement, amount given some subsidy. There are no follow-up. So that list is a cumulative list, which when we went to the field, is no relationship. So we took care to identify the farmers who just started SRI within the 1 or 2 years period. So then also we had a sample 70 extension officials and NGOs, scientists and key farmers. Study period 2010, we confirmed that in 2009-10 that the agriculture period was a more or less a normal period. Then of course the SRI components are more or less as the earlier speakers was outlined, the single seedling, transplanting and engrave, square planting, corner weeding, and even water is 2.5 centimeter water. This water component was not covered in the study because most of the farmers feel there was no perfect leveling. And second, canal irrigation was at irregular intervals, so farmers are irrigating at the normal water. And also the groundwater also pumping was also done. That's a mixture of things, so we cannot generalize the water saving using only survey method. It will give a bias result. Then another thing is a major contribution of this paper is developing an adoption score. Who are the full adopter, who are the partial adopter, who are the low adopter or no adopter. So that we are carefully brainstormed and devised a scale. This is the scale, adoption score scale. So these are the recommended practices, this is the conventional. So the deviation is used giving the score. It is a 1, 2, 3 score. Aggregate score is a maximistral, maybe 3 and less. Accordingly, we defined who are the adopter or not adopter. That means within the score, full adopter somehow score is 12. That means 4 practices at the higher level, score 3, 4 into 3, 12. Like kind of low adopters below. Poor practices, they may adopt one practice fully, others may not be adopting. Partial adopter score between 7 and 11. We are very careful in defining, checking, and then finally we say this may be the, probably the nearest concept that we can use for differentiating the adoption levels. Then we said this result, we divide the regions, states accordingly. First, another important thing is a non-SRI. We initially planned to have a control non-SRI fields. But during the course of the survey, in the beginning itself, it was surprising. When you go with the linearly, the form size is increasing, rise form size. The SRI is more or less ranging from 1 to maximum 2 acres. So that's a scale neutral, more or less. SRI is more or less scale neutral. So a farmer having 4 acres paddy, maybe 1 acre SRI. Farmer having 5 acres paddy, maybe 1.5 or 2 or 1 acre SRI. So the remaining conventional is a control. This has an added advantage because other socio-economic parameters are controlled within the SRI and non-SRI within the farmer's field. So we have an equal plot of non-SRI comparison. That we actually incidentally we got that information when she initiated the survey within 2 weeks of time. So they removed the control farmers separately. So we put that as a control plot.
Keeping is not actually visible clearly shown here. Do you have differences in yield according to the level of adoption also? Farmers adopting all practices for the way you define adopters, number of practices adopted.
So, okay. Non-SRI, then difference? Definitely. This is a general table any policy maker want to know. Okay? Okay, what is the SRI yield in the state level? It is giving you some kind of a positive signal. For an aggregate level, it's a positive signal. So the message is, SRI is, if you go to, actually it varies between, you can see this column. Difference 9.2 quintals, 7.3 in western region, 9 like that, it goes to region. Maximum is almost 1 ton, minimum is 0.2 ton, that's what the range. And also we also identified, for example, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, why there is a high difference in the yield. That's also very interesting. We proved that one. Whereas in Tamil Nadu, it is low. 6 point, almost Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, why the difference? Both adjacent states, west growing states, we proved that difference also. It is interesting because the way which the base yield is controlled and the current yield is obtained, and how the extension intervention and the practice adopted, that also affected. That means it is a weighted average of the partial low and high adopter yield. Okay? So that means it will be a giving skew distribution of the yield when you go and aggregate it. So we thought we can go for the adoption level. So all India level it is 8.5 quintals. There is a gross income, gross margin is 18% increase, whereas 22% yield increase. Luckily, another good thing about SR is the cost of production, maybe almost 29, actually it's ranging from 10 to 30% reduction in the cost of production quintal. This is merely an arithmetic because when the yield increases, definitely your cost goes down. So it's arithmetic. So cost is comparatively lower in the SRI because there is a marginal increase in the yield. So you can look at the figure, you can see 3 or 5 states are little above the yield increase, it's an incremental yield increase, others are below that one. So this will give a scope for future identification and priority areas. Now coming to Malik question. Okay, now we grouped because the space we only grouped the region wise percentage. And the big report will give all irrigation, soil type analysis, everything. So the region wise you can see the low partial adoption as per our definition is the percentage of farmers. You can see 20% of the farmers only full adopters. Almost 40 are partial low adopters. You recall our definition of full and partial low. There's a yield in non-SRI parcels, you can see, the last one is important. Yield increase in SRI under different adoption, this is very, very important there. Research is important. So the yield, actually, the full, in the case of the All India level, you can see almost 31% yield increase in the full adoption, 25% is the partial, and 15% the low. So this should be used as a weight to multiply by the overall yield. You will get an aggregate yield at the state level. So these are the typical weights. So that means only 20% of the farmers' yield is boosting the overall state level yield because of the increase, 40% increase. So the graph almost showing the same result. So finally you can see the yield difference between SRI, non-SRI and a different adoption level is full adoption is almost you can get 11.2 quintals, 9.5 point. This is the final message you want to convey. So in the case of full adoption, 11.5, the additional is getting. Then 10 quintal, 5 quintal per load. So all are getting some yield. All SRI farmers, irrespective of adoption level, are getting some yield, but the yield is possibly made higher than the full adoption. But unfortunately, full adoption is only 20%. That's the key message.
Just a
Because the base yield is already high. So I am a good student, I am already getting 95 marks. Because of additional input, I am getting 97 marks. So, 2 marks. Another person getting 65 marks, he is getting 80 marks now. Like that.
State yield itself is given.
So, marginal yield is only available in those states where the base yield is already assessed.
State yield is an average.
Yeah.
It will be 20% above average and some
percent
below average.
State as a whole is.
So, below average people did not participate.
No, no. If you compare the states, suppose if you take Orissa, Bihar, and Tamil Nadu, you can see the difference. A small flickering in eastern state may flicker more yield compared to southern states. That is the difference.
So, what is the message that good performers need not go for SRI?
No, the marginal incremental benefit is less.
So that's why even the marginal increment is less.
Yeah, sure, that's one of the conclusions.
I think, yeah. Then
some people are asking, which component is giving more yield? Okay, you put a, first you adopt a level, but some farmer adopting one, some farmer adopting. So we took the, all the fully adopted farmers, then we segregated the data according to the practices. Starting from C1 is industrially single square planting. Then also you can see the. So the maximum yield is C1, C2, C3. Combination of practice of course gives the maximum yield. Like single practice also giving yield. So this means even doing some, sincerely some one component also giving some margin yield. But farmers are very clever. They will select those components which is easy for them in terms of labor and other effort and other things. So they can easily. That may be one of the reasons why there is a partial adoption or low adoption because they were very choosy in selecting some adoption levels. So that's why it starts to be decomposed that also according to the component wise also. This will help them. Okay, farmers will easily we can recommend, okay, this region, we also did it state-wise, region-wise, everything, but this is an aggregated.
So which component gives more incremental DCR?
Yeah, everything is there.
So which is that component which gives higher incremental VCR?
No, no. VCR is a notional number. Huh? You don't rely on the VCR. 4 by 2 is 2, 200 by 100 is 2.
Okay, that in terms of marginal yield.
Marginal yield, you can see, this is all the marginal yield only. You can give C1, C2, C3. Either single seeding and square planting gives the higher yield.
What is that?
Younger seeding, single seeding and square planting. C1, C2, C3. 31.3 quintals. This also you can go which region, which state also available. But overall I am giving a picture.
It's actually C1, C2, C4 that is giving the maximum, 17.5.
Yeah, sorry.
That's C1, C2, C4. C4 is right. Answer to your question. That
combination seems to be the most optimal. Yeah, this also changes according to the state and regions.
Not optimal.
This is a concept we introduced in the calculation. This will be relating to later on for disadoption or partial adoption. Why farmers are not, even though it's not a technique, SR is not a technique, it's a practice. Practice means more flexibility, okay? Why farmers are not going, even though it is provenly, scientifically, say, IED. Anything good is farmers will pick up. Why it is not going? There is a hidden cost, called the transaction cost. Farmers opportunity cost is the major one, opportunity cost of this labor. Here you put it 20 years back, zero. Now it is 300% opportunity cost. Why I should go and chase an officer to get a corona reader? I can go for a conventional. So like that, we waste all this effort in mobile. It's not input cost. All this effort to mobilizing the subsidy, corona reading, marker, single shading nursery, everything farmers has to run. First of the time, maybe there will be a demonstration, some people will give some seedling. But second season, if he wants to go, he has to chase everybody. This is the transaction cost. We presented when many people told in many states, this is underestimated. First, they were not thinking about this cost. But when I explained, they say this is the major cost. That may be constraining the SRA adoption. So this will directly go to the policies. How the government can relax this cost, minimize the cost. So this is the major, actually it is underestimated. But still it gives some kind of a 2 to 3% of the cultivation cost. But this is a very qualified cost. It's not easy to share it because he has to run for several kilometers, waiting and other things. Then the next year, he got up and he is leaving that practice. That was the major one.
The transaction cost is one of the costs which should be addressed.
This is the suggested component. Then we sort it out from the on the sample. From the regions, we sorted out in descending order which practices give the highest and which is soil type, which irrigation source, which was going along another 3-4 columns. But because irrigation type is a flexible one, sometimes it is supplemented, rain fed, so many things. To avoid the complexities, we put the soil type as a given type, it's a fixed one. Then these are some of the combination which the government, each state can, because it's a state administration, it's a region, we give the state-wise presentation. Suppose if the Andhra Pradesh, C1, C2, C4, they can concentrate. They need not put on C3, not much important, based on these are the result shows. These are the possible combinations of the SRA component which can be focused instead of the package component. This may be selective. Irrigation is not included because it's highly varying. Suppose if Central India is a rain fed, so Eastern India partially supplemented, Southern India fully irrigated, it goes like that. Major concern, you can recall all the three presentations, more or less matching. These three presentations are independent presentation, not included in our studies. So you can see that one. This is the best of irrigation shielding. That's why many farmers afraid. They want to put two shielding, three shieldings. Poor water control, this is a major problem in SRA. If you want a single shielding, unless a perfect land leveling, it will damage. Scarcity of groundwater location regions. Erratic power supply, you cannot irrigate. As such, SRA requires 2.5 cm alternative days always. But how do you measure how to irrigate it? That's a problem. Poor land damage causes water logging. Because of the government program pushing the SRA, they are putting in coastal areas everywhere, water logging, crop is damaged. Lack of complete knowledge on all the SRA components, practices, farmers. Lack is a major problem actually, particularly for corn weeding, transplanting, nobody is willing to come. Because single seeding planting is a very, very difficult one. Corn weeding is a very treacherous job, nobody wants to come, particularly in paddy, puddle soil, very difficult. Non-suitable marker for spacing and other. These are the major concerns we aggregated from all the states, maybe matching with the area presentation also. Even this one, what are our recommendations? It's a general recommendation, may be suitable to most of the states.
First one is, suppose our paddy area in India is 42 million hectares. Production is almost 90 million tonnes. Okay? Almost 2 to 3 rice, but all our resources are paddy. So in the future, given the population increase and other things, we need, say, 20 million tonnes additionally. Where to target? If SRA gives 1 tonnes additional yield, you divide 20 million tonnes divided by 1. You need some 2 lakhs or something. Where to target that area? So this will be useful to target the region where SRA has more potential. Don't go SRA everywhere. Where SRA has more potential, you target the that regions, map it using GPS or GIS, then target that region. Even we try to map that using GPS, but it takes some more time. So targeting the regions for potential SRA may be a good intervention. Second one is selective SRA component. We need not go. SRA is a package. You can be still selective according to the location, according to the farmers, soil type, irrigation type, and etc. Then that will give a more leverage to the farmers to follow up easily. Then doing it differently. Even within that one, allow instead of one shielding, two shielding is also okay. Not much difference in the simply flexibility. So the people will come for transplanting easily instead of picking up one shielding. So we give flexibility within the selected packages. Machine transplanting. This is very important. Now already machines are coming up, imported machines from Japan, Korea. They are doing precisely 1 or 2 shieldings. 1 acre, 4,000 rupees, finish. Planting is done, 1 acre. They also raise the nursery according to your taste. Which variety, they do that one. You have to give 3 weeks advance notice. They prepare a mat nursery, come and plant. You have to keep the land leveled. That's all your job. Now we are requesting the machinery companies, why can't you do the land leveling also? If they do the perfect land leveling, they will come and plant it, get the 4,000-5,000 rupees, buy it. If you go with the labor, it costs 6,000 rupees. And labor is not available. So machine, we are doing some experimentation in Krishna Basin, Godavari Basin. It is picking up very well. SRA is also picking up. So that's why. Machine transplant is small machines. It costs 9 lakh rupees. Intensive capacity building program to the farmers and extension of very important. Most of the presentation also for lack of capacity of the farmer in certain practices. Target government program. There are several government programs, RKVY, on state government programs, all are in anticipated manner. Target them, target the area, put the SRA focus. That's possible. Long time action, this is very important. There is a claim from the soil scientist where the additional yield is coming from SRA. Where nursery is coming from. They are telling nothing but their SRA is because of the fruitfulness root growth, more spacing, retaining all the nutrient in the soil in the first year. Second year, if you not demonstrate with organic manure and other things, it will go down. Third year, farmers will become disadapted. That was the scientific inference given by the soil scientists. Why farmers are not adapting? Yield is declining in the second year onward because it is taking all the nutrient in the first year, second year. So we have to demonstrate with a more organic manure, not just a fertilizer. So long-term experimentation should be necessary for 4-5 years in SRA fields. Then we will see what are the nutrients will be available.
So there is a meeting.
Yeah. Yes, same thing, yeah. But it will be done by an institution which is not biased to SRA. That is very important. Yeah. Now the periodical updating. Nowhere SRA area is data is available. If the government is targeting 1,000 hectares this year, okay, 1,000. Next year, 2,000. Cumulating 3,000. What about the disadapters? No adapters. That is not accounted. So the periodical updating of the SRA is very important. That is missing. So I think these are the major conclusions. So we are planning to repeat the same study with the same set of farmers after 2 years. Then that will become a disadapter study. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Pani.